Hi, this is Graham from Jenham's Astro. Right now there are lots of opportunities to image the planets. We've got Venus, Jupiter, Saturn and Mars all visible at different times of the night. This video pulls together some of the lessons I've learned when trying to image with a small telescope. So it's basically a list of do's and don'ts. Hopefully it'll be of some use. So I'd say one of the main bits of advice is to prepare all your kit in advance. Don't just rush out there on the night and screw it all together having not done a bit of planning. Do a bit of preparation. I'd suggest, if possible, use a webcam rather than a digital SLR. The webcam is going to capture a much smaller area of sky. You're going to produce much smaller, more manageable files. Having a dedicated planetary astro camera is, I would say, a nice to have. It's definitely not an essential. You can produce some really good images just using a cheap webcam. You can buy adapters or buy kits to allow you to adapt them into the focuser draw tube for your telescope. This is one of the main lessons I've learned, is to line up whatever finderscope you've got, whether it's a red dot finder or a Telrad or a conventional optical finderscope, line it up with the main telescope. Do this very precisely. Check it and check it again. Do it during the day. If you have got something like a webcam and you don't have a good alignment, you can waste a lot of time not even finding the planet that you're trying to image. You'll be sweeping back and forth unless you've got a go-to scope. If you haven't, you can waste a lot of time. You can avoid that by lining up the finder scope in advance and making everything nice and rigid so that you know that you can rely on that pointing accuracy. Next thing, pretty obvious, charge up any camera or laptop batteries in advance. If you've got batteries in your mount, do the same thing, get those all ready to go. Use a good Barlow lens. I've got 2x and 3x lenses. Get familiar with them, make sure you're happy with the quality of the image that you get. If you're using too much magnification, then you're gonna have a problem getting a good image. Clean out any dust from both the Barlow and maybe from the sensor you have on the webcam before you go and set up. Now you can do this just by pointing your camera using a sort of live view arrangement on your laptop. Look at the bright sky during the day and just make sure you haven't got any obvious specks of dust in the field. You're aiming to get a focal ratio of around f/30. So for example, if you have an f/10 focal ratio telescope, then and a 3x Barlow, then that's getting you to that ratio of the magic number f/30. And why is that important? Well, really, we're just trying to achieve a certain image scale, which means a certain number of pixels across the face of the planet when you image it. If there aren't enough pixels, then you get a pixelated image and it's just not pleasing. So aim for f/30. Use an app to figure out where the planet's going to be. I use SkyGuide, but there are plenty of alternatives, and it allows you to think in advance, to look, hold up the phone to the sky and see where you think the planet's going to rise, see what time it is, see what other features are going to be in the sky that might help you to find the planet if it's not a bright one. Use an app on your phone to do that. And then on the night, use the information you've learned from that app to put the scope in the right place. You're trying to avoid a situation where the planet rises and goes immediately behind a tree. You could avoid that with a little bit of advanced planning. Now, these aren't quite so obvious, but when you're trying to image a planet at high magnification, one of the major factors that influences the quality of the image is the stability of the air that you're looking through. Now, some days you can't have any influence on that, but there are some pitfalls that you can avoid. So don't image over the roof of your neighbor's house unless you can avoid it. Don't image over a parked car, especially one that's been sat in the sun or has been driven. It's going to radiate off a lot of heat and it's going to disturb the air above the car. And also, don't image over a hot surface. So I've got a barbecue here, or a big expanse of tarmac or road. Ideally, image over a surface, perhaps grass. Okay, so let your scope cool down. Different telescope designs need more or less time to cool down. Certainly if you've got something like a Maxitov, I use a Celestron C90 in lots of the videos on this channel, make sure you let it cool down for half an hour after you take it outside. Some of the designs of scope, you don't really need to do this. Do a basic alignment. Now, you can, if you're doing a minute or two of planetary video capture at a time, you don't need a perfect alignment like you would do for long-term deep sky astrophotography. So do a basic alignment. Line up the mount with Polaris. You can use a compass app on your phone, for example, and then you can approximately line up a mount good enough for the purposes of capturing a minute or two of video. But it is worth aligning, as we'll see. If you don't have a basically good alignment, then you can have problems when you're trying to keep the image of the planet within the field that you're capturing. Now, this has to be the main rule of planetary photography. Focus, focus, focus. It's quite difficult to focus on what can be a wobbly, blurry planetary image that you get on the video. So what I tend to do is I slew the telescope towards a bright star that's in a similar part of the sky. And then I focus on that very, very carefully. You can do that with a live view app, for example, on your PC, and then you can use certain tools like a Bartinoff mask, which goes over the front of the telescope and produces a nice diffraction image that helps you to precisely focus. But the point is to spend your time getting a precise focus. That is probably the one aspect of planetary imaging that will make the most difference to the result that you get. Capture video rather than stills. Well, we've mentioned a webcam already, so there should be no surprise. It's worth reviewing a few of the video files whilst you're outside. You can do it very quickly, takes a few seconds, click on the file. I even run the odd Registax cycle through of some of the files just to get a basic idea. Am I on the right lines? Is there something that's, is the focus good, or is it way off? It's worth doing that. Only takes a minute or two. You can do that outside. I've mentioned Registax. There obviously are other apps to process video files. Don't waste your time if the image is very unstable. You can't always tell when you go out of a night whether the night is going to be a good one. If you find that you can't get a stable image, then maybe wait an hour or give it another try another day. Okay, here's a few examples of these pitfalls, these do's and don'ts that I've been talking about. So on this first video, Saturn is drifting towards the bottom of the frame. Basically, the mount is not well enough aligned for the job we need to do. This time, the same drift is apparent. I've used the manual slow motions to centralize the image and let it drift again. Maybe I'll get more time, sufficient time to capture the good image. But you can process a file like this and centralize the planet in each frame, but it's better to just align the mount. This time, it's looking good. Good image brightness, more stable, but the image is fading. Is it a cloud? No, it's gone behind an obstruction. This time, everything's looking good. Brightness is good, but I think there seems to be some noise. So I stop and process the file, and you can see that there is some noise. I don't know why it's there, but it gives you an example of why it's worth processing sometimes as you go along. And then finally, for Saturn, this is looking the best of all of them. Good view of the Cassini division, good level of exposure, and planet is stable in the frame. So this was the best of a long evening of trial and error. And if you put this file through Registax without being an expert in wavelets and all of those things, I'm pretty happy with the result from a 90mm scope. So moving on to Jupiter, Here's an example of a decent enough night. It's not the best, but you can see the red spot, you can see some of the equatorial bands, and you can see belts, and you can see a moon over to one side of the planet. This is enough to know that it's worth processing. And here you go, the Registax image is pretty good. It brings out a lot of detail that you really can't see in real time, but there are enough good frames within the file that you can stack and get a good result. And finally, moving on to Venus, if you've got a bright planet that's low in the sky, you're going to get all sorts of turbulence and you can get colour separation, as you can see in this video. But sometimes it's worth persevering. You can stack and align and you can get rid of a lot of that noise and produce a decent result. So hopefully this video is useful. I'm definitely not an expert in imaging, but it shows you that if you avoid some of the obvious mistakes, then you can get some half decent images of the planets with a small scope. And it's quite good fun. So thanks for watching.